friends, so today in this video, I'm gonna teach you a method by which you can find out the approximate root of any given equation. And that method is called as Newton-Raphson method. Now, let's say you have been given an equation, and that equation is, let's say it is quadratic or cubic or some higher degree equation, and you want to find out the root of that equation. Then by using Newton-Raphson method, we can get the root of the equation. Now, what is the geometric meaning of it? So let's understand it first. So let's say this is the x and y axis, and let's say we have a curve. So I'm considering one curve over here. So let's say this is the curve, and let's say the equation of this curve is y equal to f of x, or we'll say that f of x is equal to 0. So the root of the equation is nothing but that the point of intersection of this curve with x axis. So wherever this curve cuts the x axis at the point, and that point is called as root of that equation or that curve. Now, to get this value, we are gonna use the algebraic method of Newton-Raphson method. But if you want to use the geometric method, then it is done by using or by taking the help of tangent. So we generally use the method of tangent to get the roots by geometric method. But here we are gonna use the algebraic method. So in algebraic method, we will consider one equation f of x. So here I'll say, let y is equal to f of x is the equation for which we want to find out the root. Or you can say that f of x is equal to 0. Now, what is the approach? So initially, what we do is we consider certain values of x, and we find out the values of f of x for each value of x. So let's say we are considering one value of x as x1. So we'll find out the value of f of x1. Then we'll consider x as x2, some other value of x, we'll find out f of x2. And we will observe whether the value of f of x1 is less than 0 and value of x2 is greater than 0. Because by Newton-Raphson method, we say whenever the value of the given function is less than 0 and greater than 0, then between those two values our root lies. So it might possible that you will not get less than 0 and greater than 0 condition in two roots. So you have to check the third root as well. So you might get here less than 0, again less than 0, and you might get that greater than 0 in third case. So we will consider that second and third case, because that time the second case will be less than 0 and third case will be greater than 0. So always remember, whenever we get the value of function as less than 0 and greater than 0 for two different values, our root of that equation lies between those two values. Next, we will consider that value as our initial root, and we will start with the formula. So the formula is x of n plus 1 is equal to x of n minus f of xn by f dash of xn. Now guys, whatever is the initial root that we are considering, we call it as x0. Now that root will be between x2 or x3, or I'll say that for the function, or I'll say that when the function is less than 0 and when the function is greater than 0, those two values will be considered as the range, and we will take the value of root or the value of initial root as one of the value from both of them. So here we'll start with x0. So since we have initial root x0, we'll consider n as 0. So in this formula, we will put n equal to 0, 1, 2, and so on. So when we put n is 0, here we will get x0 minus f of x0 upon f dash of x0. So x0 means the initial root, whatever that we are considering. f of x0 means value of function f of x at that point x0, we'll put it here, and f dash of x0 is nothing but the derivative of this function, that is f dash of x, and in that f dash of x we will put that root x0, and by doing that we will here get x1, because n is 0, so 0 plus 1 is 1, we'll get value of x1. Now we will use that value of x1 in the next approximation or in next iteration to get the value of x2. Next we will use that value of x2 in next iteration to get the value of x3, and so on. So we'll continue till we get the two consecutive iterations as same, and whenever we get the same value in consecutive iteration we stop and we call as that is the root of our equation. Now to understand this method, let's take one example. So here we have to compute the real root of the equation x log x to the base 10 minus 1.2 is equal to 0, correct up to 3 decimal places using Newton-Raphson method. So let's start. So here what we'll do is, here we will say let f of x is equal to x log of x to the base 10 minus 1.2. Now we'll find out the range between which our root lies, and for that we have to take different values of x. So first of all, I'll consider value of x as 1. So I'll find out f of 1. It will be 1 log of 1 to the base 10 minus 1.2. Then I'll consider x as 2. We'll find out 2 log of 2 to the base 10 minus 1.2. Now if you'll check these two values in calculator, then here you'll get minus 1.2, and here you'll get minus 0.5979. It means we are getting both values less than 0. So as I said you in the steps, that whenever we are getting consecutive values less than 0 or greater than 0, will not accept it. So it means we want one value should be less than 0 and one value should be greater than 0. So hence I'll find out the next value, that is for x equal to 3. So here we will get 3 log of 3 to the base 10 minus 1.2 is equal to, and if you will check this value in calci, you will get 0.2313, which is greater than 0. And now guys, you can see that the value of f of x is greater than 0 for x equal to 3 and less than 0 for x equal to 2. So here I can say, since f of x changes the sign from negative to positive as x goes from 2 to 3, there is root between 2 and 3. So guys, our root lies between 2 and 3. Now to get that root, we will use the Newton-Raphson method. So we know the formula of Newton-Raphson method. I'll show you here. So this is the formula. Now if you want to use this formula, then we have to find out the values of f of xn, f dash of xn, and so on. Also we have to consider the initial root x0. Now if you'll see here, then here we got the two values of x. Now which value we should consider as x0? So if you'll observe carefully, then these are the values of function. Now if you'll see, then this value 0.2313 is closer to 0. If you draw it on the number line, then 0.2313 will be here, whereas minus 0.5979 will be somewhere here. So since this is more closer to x equal to 0, we'll consider our x as 3, and I'll say x0 is equal to 3. So now I'll say, therefore x0 is equal to 3. Now let's find out the value of f of xn. So f of x, we have this. So f of xn will be xn log of xn to the base 10 minus 1.2. Here I'll write xn माइनस सॉरी इनटू लॉग ऑफ एक्स एन टू द बेस 10 माइनस 1.2. नेक्स्ट वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट एफ डैश ऑफ एक्स एन. नाउ टू फाइंड आउट द एफ डैश ऑफ एक्स एन वी हैव टू टेक डेरिवेटिव ऑफ दिस एफ ऑफ एक्स एन. एंड फॉर दैट व्हाट वी विल डू इज विल कंसीडर दिस लॉग टर्म इन बेस e फॉर्म. देन ओनली वी कैन फाइंड आउट द डेरिवेटिव. सो हियर आई विल से इट इज एक्स एन इंटू लॉग ऑफ एक्स एन अपॉन लॉग ऑफ 10 टू द बेस e माइनस 1.2. एंड नाउ विल फाइंड आउट द डेरिवेटिव इन दिस केस. सो दिस इज आर एफ ऑफ एक्स एंड नाउ विल फाइंड आउट द एफ डैश ऑफ एक्स एन. सो दिस इज जस्ट एफ ऑफ एक्स एन. सो दिस इज यूवी रूल. वी विल गेट द डेरिवेटिव ऑफ एक्स एन एज 1 एंड दिस टर्म एज इट इज. सो दिस टर्म इज नथिंग बट लॉग ऑफ एक्स एन टू द बेस 10 प्लस एक्स एन एज इट इज. एंड डेरिवेटिव ऑफ दिस टर्म इज 1 अपॉन लॉग ऑफ 10 टू द बेस e एज इट इज. एंड लॉग ऑफ एक्स एन विल गिव अस 1 अपॉन एक्स एन दैट इज हियर माइनस डेरिवेटिव ऑफ दिस टर्म इज 0. नाउ वी कैन कैंसिल दिस एक्स एन एंड एक्स एन. सो वी विल गेट लॉग ऑफ एक्स एन टू द बेस 10 एंड हियर वी कैन से दैट इट इज प्लस log of 10 to the base e inverse. So this is the value of f dash of xn. Now if you'll calculate this value in the calculator, then you will get value as 0.43. so I'll say here it is log of xn to the base 10 plus 0.4343, and this is the value of f dash of xn. Now we got f value of f of xn, f dash of xn. Now we'll say by Newton-Raphson method, xn plus 1 is equal to xn minus f of xn upon f dash of xn. So this will give us xn minus, now value of f of xn is this, that is xn log xn to the base 10 minus 1.2. So xn log of xn to the base 10 minus 1.2 whole upon f dash of xn, that is this value. So log of xn to the base 10 plus 0.4343. And now we'll put the value of n as 0, 1, 2 and so on. So let's start. So here I'll say when n is equal to 0, we will get x1 as x0 minus x0 log of x0 to the base 10 minus 1.2 upon log of x0 to the base 10 plus 0.4343. And we have considered the value of x0 as 3. So now we'll substitute x0 as 3. So we will get 3 minus 3 log 3 to the base 10 minus 1.2 whole upon log of 3 to the base 10 plus 0.4343. Now if you'll put these values in calculator, then you'll get answer as Now this is the value of x1, or this is our new root. Now we will use this value of x1 in the next iteration. So for that I'll put n equal to 1. So this will become x2. So here I'll say therefore x2 is equal to x1 minus x1 log of x1 to the base 10 minus 1.2 whole upon log of x1 to the base 10 plus 0.4343. Now here at x1 we will put the value 2.74615, and if you will calculate this in calculator, then you will get 2.7406 as the value of x2. Now again we will use this value of x2 in next iteration. So we'll find out x3. So x3 will be x2 minus x2 log of x2 to the base 10 minus 1.2 upon log of x2 to the base 10 plus 0.4343. Now here we'll put this value of x2, that is 2.7406, and if you'll calculate this in calculator, then you will find that the value of x3 is also 2.7406. It means the value of x2 and x3 is same. So whenever value of x is same in consecutive iteration, that time we stop and we say this is the root. So here I'll say the root of the given equation is 2.7406. Now guys, if you want to verify whether your root is right or wrong, then what you can do is you can take this value of x, resubstitute it in the question, and you will find that this value of this function will be 0. And if you get it as 0, then your root is right. Thank you.